Today on Samcraft, we're going to be taking a look at the xTool D1 Pro 20 Watt Laser Engraver, Honeycomb Bed Air Assist, and Enclosure. Hey everyone, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. That's right, today's video is all about the xTool. I have a lot of people that have left me comments, a lot of questions and emails for the past several months saying, hey, what about the xTool? xTool this, xTool that. I never had one until now. So this is going to be a first part of a series of mini videos and different kind of things where you'll see the xTool used. I've actually already put out one or two of those videos before this one, so you definitely notice there is an xTool in my shop if you follow the channel. If not, be sure to look down below. I'll put all the xTool videos in one big playlist. That way you can go there, see them all, and click and watch whatever you'd like to. In this video, I'm going to go through assembly and packaging, talk about some issues, complaints, and problems that I had, and of course, do several material tests. xTool is one of those companies where if you watch any videos and the people look at the packaging or show it, they are surprised or they are raving, they love it. And there's good reason for that. Not every company takes as much care and attention to detail as xTool does, whether it be the cardboard boxes they use for shipping, internal cardboard boxes, foam packaging that is custom fit for every device, and the care they put in making sure your machine arrives safely. In addition to great product packaging, xTool does a phenomenal job giving you high quality instruction manuals, assembly guides, quick start guides, product insert cards, and every bit of physical paper literature you would want with a machine. That kind of stuff means a lot to a customer, and not all companies do that. xTool, however, really excels at it. There are a ton of other creator videos on YouTube that go through the very detailed, hands-on, walk you through step-by-step assembly of this machine, so I'm not going to do that. And really, I don't need to do that. The instructions and the assembly process is straightforward and very simple. This next segment is part of the complaints and issues with the machine. First and foremost, cable management on this machine being labeled as Pro is nowhere near what I would consider to be Pro quality. They do not use drag link chains. They rely on wire looms and zip ties, which is okay, but definitely not Pro in my book. In addition to just visually looking a little bit clunky, there are some serious problems you may have with those zip ties, depending on how you route your cables. I actually had a near catastrophe. I want to share that with you guys here real quick so you can see what happened to me, hopefully prevent it, but also kind of further illustrate how, xTool kind of dropped the ball on cable management. All right, here's the problem. This wire right here, the one that goes to the laser head, originally it's around this area like it's supposed to be, like the manual says. This down here flops around and drags against these zip ties that are put in by the factory. Once this goes back and forth enough, on my instance, it caught here, pinned it, and when it went this way, it had nothing but just to rip the metal pull until it finally stopped, and I killed power to the machine as quick as I could. So what I'm going to do is take this wire off of the zip ties right here and put it on the top. It's not going to be as pretty, it's not going to be as flashy, but it's going to be out of the way, I hope. I'm going to put it in a place so that it can freely move left and right and get this up and out of the way. Because even though this moving left to right is one issue, when it homes and comes all the way against this rail, it also kind of binds up. So I'm going to try and kill both of these birds with the one stone called moving the cable, proper cable management. Don't do it this way. Try it the other way. All right, everything looks good now. The last thing I'm going to do is double check my wires here. Make sure I just didn't totally destroy this thing. Looks all right. And I'm gonna bend that metal up. I'll bend it by hand. There we go. I think we're ready to rock and roll now. So I totally dodged a big one there. I'm glad that nothing physically broke, nothing was totally destroyed, and I have changed the wire routing and it's been fine since. I've run probably 20, 25 jobs on the machine since then and never had another snag or issue. So good. That crisis was averted. My next complaint with the machine is that focusing the laser head is clunky and cumbersome. They do give you the little metal kickstand you flip down, lower the laser head on top of your material, and that's easy, I suppose. My problem with that is with Slate, especially with Slate, when I kick that kickstand down, lock the laser head in place, and go to fold the kickstand up, if I'm not very careful, it will scratch the Slate. That's not the end of the world. It's easy to kind of rub that out and get the scratch taken away, But the fact that your focusing device locks in and really just kind of wedges itself between the laser and the material, I'm not a fan of that. I honestly really prefer the freestanding, free-floating little aluminum cylinders that other companies give you, because it allows me to move the laser away without having the focus device attached and run the risk of scratching my material. Another thing I honestly don't like is their manual thumb screw adjustment for focusing the laser. It is not a very smooth operation. The dovetail that the laser head slides into on the gantry, being the same material as the laser head itself, they have a tendency to stick and get hung up on each other a little bit. This just means that it's not as smooth and easy to do, and the thumb screw adjustment just doesn't give the whole pro feeling to what's labeled as a pro machine. I would much rather see a hands-free, maybe a knob on the top Z-height adjustment, something similar to their competitors such as Otor and Jimitsu do, rather than the thumb screw on the side to lock it in place and just something different. The same kind of concept applies to the focusing knob, which is on the right side of the diode head, the little thumb screw where you can adjust where your beam, whether it focuses on the surface or below. That's also clunky, although it's not really something I use much of. It is kind of annoying. The next thing I don't like is the placement of the power and USB cords. Now, don't get me wrong, this is not something that only xTool is at fault of. I think most laser manufacturers, for whatever reason, they want the power cord and USB cord right up front. That doesn't make sense from a practical application when a device is sitting on your workbench. In my case, here at LaserTown, the laser is here, but my computer and my screen is behind the machine, over there. Having to route the cords, or in my case, buy longer ones to reach around and to the front of the machine, just doesn't make sense. I don't know when it would make sense for anyone, unless they physically have the machine right beside their computer, and it's not an issue, I guess. I would just prefer to have the connection ports, power, and all that on the back of the machine. Something like you see with larger CO2 lasers, large commercial machines, and stuff like that. As far as the enclosure, I'm honestly very surprised that I like it as much as I do. I walked into the enclosure realm with the xTool a little bit, not really thinking it was going to be up to par. That's because my experience with an enclosure has been the metal one with the Otor LaserMaster 2 Pro, and this one from xTool is not metal. It is a stiffer material, but overall it's flexible. It also goes together with Velcro sections, no bolts, no screws, and I was concerned that it would be, flopsy-mopsy. I'm happy to say that I actually really like the enclosure. It is plenty strong enough for its uses. It actually holds together very well. It does a great job at extracting the fumes and keeping the smokes and smells out of my workshop. And this top viewing window is very, very nice. It's very large, much larger than what the Otor gives with their enclosure, which makes it nice to keep an eye on your projects, look at things, but still keep everything contained in the enclosure. The one complaint I do have with the enclosure are with the straps that they attach to the lid that's supposed to snap to the sides. They are too short. If they are to be attached, it holds the lid in a way where when you let go, it falls right back down. What I did is actually super glued the straps to the lid and don't even have them in my equation. Whenever I want to open the enclosure, I open it, flip it back, and let the lid rest back there, either on the enclosure or, in my case, the duct fan piping. It's not a big deal, but it is something that they didn't really do good quality control or design on with the straps because they're completely useless for me. To backpedal on the completely useless portion of the straps, I actually did find a use for them. I have my air hose routed for the air assist through the strap in between it and the lid, and it keeps the air hose up, but gives enough slack to let it be connected to the laser and move around with no problems. I previously had the air hose going through the grommet on the side of the enclosure where the power cord for the fan runs, but it had an issue where the hose kind of had too much slack, pulled them too much slack, or something happened when the machine went to home. That hose got between the gantry and the back frame and caused the stepper motors to crash, grind gears, and pretty much otherwise make horrible noises. Since moving it to the lid in between the strap, I've not had any problems, so that's good. Therefore, the straps are useful, I guess. The honeycomb board that you can get from xTool is very, very strong, durable, it is heavy, it is well made, and honestly one of the best ones I've ever used. I kind of get a chuckle when manufacturers put grid marks or ruler marks on your honeycomb beds, yet they don't have it attached to your laser. It kind of really doesn't make sense, doesn't match, and the fact that they put the origin point bottom left, but the xTool's origin point is top left, really doesn't make any sense. So ignore that. Otherwise, it is a very good honeycomb bed. It is extremely durable, rigid, quite hefty, and they include the aluminum panel on the back to protect your work surface if you have this just sitting on top of a workbench. I don't use this all the time. It's why you see it mostly stored over here to the side, because I have a grid board that I use for engraving. But when I want to cut material, this is easy to grab, put in a machine, and go from there. The air assist is routed over here between the enclosure and the wall, so you can't really see it much, but it works really well. For its size, it is relatively quiet, but it still puts out enough air to work great. The pump itself doesn't put off any vibration at all as far as what you feel on the table. It has good dampening feet built in. The inline switch in the cord is handy, and really, there's not much to complain about. I will say that I ran the air assist for about an hour solid, and the motor, the metal part of the air pump, did get pretty warm to the touch. Not necessarily burned you hot, but warmer than you would want to really leave your hands on long term. So if you have this air pump, make sure it is given plenty of space to dissipate heat. Don't put it somewhere next to flammables or things where it may be exposed to too much heat. Otherwise, it's great. It's small, it's compact, and works very well. With a diode laser such as this, there are a ton of different materials you can engrave, things you can cut, and a variety of uses. For my material tests, I did two things. I did cutting tests with wood and plywood, and engraving tests with slate. These are the two medias that I do 95% of my work with, and what really matter most to me. For the cutting test, I went through a variety of stock that actually you can get from xTool, things such as maple, cherry, babinga, walnut, plywood, 1/8 inch or 3 millimeter thick. This stuff cuts great. The general consensus was that I could run as fast as 7 millimeters per second at 80% power and get one pass cut through on all the 3 millimeter woods. Putting it to the true test though is to put it up against true Baltic birch plywood, not birch veneer, but true Baltic birch. With the 3 millimeter, I was able to go as fast as 7 millimeters at 80% single pass, full cut through. That was really cool. The 6 millimeter Baltic birch plywood is notoriously difficult, but the xTool did it at 5 millimeters a second, 80% power. Very nice. Surprisingly nice. As far as engraving, slate is the number one material that I engrave, and it's probably the number one thing that goes through any of my lasers for my small business. Looking at this example here, I'm able to show you that it gives wonderfully crisp results. If you look really close, there's actually a crosshatch pattern. It's not fully filled out. This was run at 15,000 millimeters per minute at 50% power. That is extremely fast. That is great results at a quick speed. Looking at my grid tile test here, you can tell that it really did cook and book, did some burning here, which is surprising. If you didn't know, a diode laser will actually melt slate. xTool definitely will melt it, so you always got to watch it while it runs. But the sweet spot for here again was right around 15,000 millimeters per minute at 50% power. So while my tests are limited to wood cutting and slate engraving, being the diode laser it is, you can do plastic, wood, leather, painted surfaces, some soft metals, and a lot of different variety of materials that you will commonly see if you're looking at videos about this machine. So there you have it, guys. There is my look at the xTool D1 Pro 20 Watt. I've had it for about 4 to 5 weeks, put it through its paces, and as you can see, it has supplanted the Auteur. It is now the laser in the corner of my workshop. The main reason for that is the more powerful diode laser allows me to run through my jobs faster, cuts my production times almost in half, and when time is money and you don't have much of either, well worth it. If you guys have any questions or comments, leave them for me down below. Remember, there is a full playlist to all my xTool videos linked down below as well. As time progresses, it'll grow. Right now, I think there's maybe 2, possibly 3 videos in there. Some things coming up very soon. Grid board design for the xTool D1, very custom thing that I've been working on, a couple of prototypes through, that's coming down the pike, as well as talking about ways to get better quality engravings, and of course the one I did the other day, talking about when it makes sense to unfocus your laser head. If you guys got any questions or comments, leave them for me down below as always. Otherwise, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.